be here, and I apologize for that long introduction, but it's so good to be here as part of the Retailers Association of India. I must thank Kumar for inviting me here, inviting NASSCOM here. And just to give you a sense of what NASSCOM stands for and why we are partners, the reality is we've had this partnership for many years at this point in time, and NASSCOM has always picked the trends early and has got after these trends. Many years ago, we had felt that every business in the world will be a technology business. And that's the reason why we chose to collaborate with RAI. And we are so happy to see that this relationship continues to make great progress. Very quickly, as some of you may know, NASSCOM today delivers almost $185 billion of exports to India. And at this point in time, our focus is to take that to close to $350 billion over the next 3 to 4 years. Just to give you an idea, that $185 billion that we are talking about at this point in time is 7.5% of India's GDP. So you can well appreciate and understand why it is important for NASSCOM to be partners with every key area in this industry in India, and to make sure that the kind of impact that India has made across the globe in any area leveraging technology is driven by this group. Let me start. I'm just going to give you a very short kind of talk, and it'll be very much focused, like my previous colleague, on the tech aspects of business. Let me start with a short video which will give you a sense of what I think is the mood in the room and in retail today. So you are there without actually being there. That's really the future. In fact, is it the future? It's already here today. I know for a fact that Safeway has already started this. So you're not actually having to visit a brick and mortar unit anymore. And while India will have to go through the evolution to get there, because there's a lot of opportunity still in the value chain, but I think we have to all start thinking about these kind of solutions and thereby adding value to our customers. So the question I would ask is, if we are to stay aligned, where do we start? Let me again mention one thing. The evolution that we have seen in the retail industry in the last 10 years, driven by changing customer requirements and also technology, and innovation is probably much higher than what we have seen in the last 100 years. And therefore, we come to that chicken and the egg kind of question. Is retail driving technology, or is technology driving retail? We have to start thinking about this question. Whichever way we look at it, I think that every customer is looking for a specific experience. First and foremost, a simpler way of interacting, a here and now service, and most importantly, personalization in every interaction across the entire value chain of retail, buying, things like that. And if you just look back at our lives, is it new? I don't think it's new, because those of us who have been using Google for many years will realize that that's exactly what Google offered us. We just had this one bar. We pointed towards something, and we said, search this. We clicked the button, and at the end of it, we got what we wanted. Now, imagine how many complex algorithms were behind it. Imagine, what are all the changes that were taking place behind, driven by technology. But for us, even today, that one outcome that was delivered by making that one click is all we are concerned about. So again, I feel that what customers are really looking forward to is simplicity. And a recent study is saying the following, and this is a simplicity index study. It says that 64% of the globe's customers are willing to pay higher value for a simpler solution as opposed to a complex solution. And here is the interesting nuance. Indian customers, 92% are actually willing to pay higher for a simpler experience as opposed to a complex experience. So again, my view is what we must be focused on is love for convenience. And again, if you look around us, you will see there are many experiences of how companies are driving this. Think of, you know, somebody spoke about Starbucks just before this. Think of the kind of solutions that the technology providers have created for Starbucks in order to drive 200-300% increase in sales in the kind of brands that are introduced in the holiday season. It comes from hyper-personalized services. All of us would be receiving, you know, promotions and emails coming to us from some of the large hotel chains. But what has actually changed is, as opposed to every one of us receiving the same mail, the hotel chains are now being driven by intelligent automation and algorithms such that each one of us is getting a different offer based on our actual buying patterns. And I just want to mention that personalization has become such an important thing. Look at what IKEA did with their latest offering around armchairs. Now, we know that one of the, you know, buzzwords, or some of the buzzwords going around in the industry, are around AR, VR, you know, things like that. But IKEA, as they polled their customers, realized that one of the important things that customers want is a personalized experience where the armchair is built around their needs as opposed to the other way around. And therefore, they have actually featured in their new range of armchairs a wireless charging device, a wireless charging device integrated into the chair itself, right? That's where retail is really going, if you ask me. While I'm talking a lot about some of these technology concepts and some of these buzzwords, let me tell you that our customers really are not walking around with these words in their heads: AR, VR, e-commerce, m-commerce, things like that. They are just looking for a simple solution. They're expecting you to solve the last mile delivery, and they're expecting to get, you know, the best impact kind of solution. And therefore, I just want to talk about what I believe is the moot question that all of us must be now asking, which is, what is it that I should focus on in terms of delivering the best high impact solution to my customers, understanding that the generation of those customers is also changing? So with that impact that technology is now creating for one of the most conservative, old state business in the world, which is insurance, which traditionally has not seen much innovation. And I think this is where NASSCOM comes in. You know, if you ask me, where is NASSCOM focused? The reality is, we see this as the biggest opportunity of the future. We think that every business in the future is really a tech business. And therefore, our focus is to ensure that we are partnering every area in terms of just enhancing the impact that they can create with their end customers. What are we doing? The first thing is, we are making sure that through our future skilling initiative, we are skilling or reskilling close to 4 million technology associates in India in order to make that huge impact. The second thing that we are doing is, we are creating centers of excellence. And I'm pretty certain that you are aware that in every state we now have, you know, great centers of excellence driving new thinking in, you know, analytics, data, big data, things like that. And again, this is to ensure that the end impact for various verticals and end customers is dramatically changing. We are at the forefront through our 10,000 startup program in terms of driving the startup thinking in this country. And you are well aware of how many new unicorns have been created. And how in the last 6 months, more unicorns have been created in this country than were created in the whole of last year. The reality is, unicorn or otherwise, all of us need this thinking, because we should now be focused on bringing that thinking in from a startup as opposed to trying and doing it ourselves. And finally, the most important thing we do at NASSCOM is advocacy with the government, where we are focused on making sure that the right rules, regulations around various things, including how to store data, is actually driven such that it's a level playing field for everyone. So I'll end here by saying that, once again, that you know, every business really is a tech business. And as I was saying to Kumar earlier, it makes a lot of sense for many of you, and those of you who are listening to this talk, to become partners, become members of NASSCOM as well, while many of our members would want to become members of RAI, collaborate with each other, and really make sure that India commands the highest impact in terms of the retail space. Thank you all very much. Have a great conference.